Hey guys, stop for 1 minute. I'll let you know when you can start. So I've got the fenders off and it's cold and rainy wet outside. So I figured I would do an indoor project, which is basically upgrading, replacing steering components. So I've got the steering damper. I've got the ball joint and tie rod ends. I've got a ball joint puller. And this should be a quick and easy thing to do. The gas tank does have some gas left in it, so I'm going to have to be nice and careful when I remove it. But my goal, hopefully, is this will take, I don't know, hour, and I'll be able to get this buttoned up pretty quickly. And moving on. Yes, I should have done this before I put the gas tank in the first time. I just didn't have the parts and I wanted to get this thing driving. Well, I'd say that's easier access, so now I can just start pulling pieces and putting in new ones.
Yeah, should be easy for you to do with those. All you got to do is remember back home, you know what I mean?
Cotter pins. Okay, so the trick that I'm going to go with is replacing one link at a time, not moving the other one. The thing is on its wheels, so hopefully the steering won't change. I can then replicate that exact distance and put that piece back in, put that one in, do this one for that side, done. I do not want to have to take this thing in for a steering alignment, so if I don't change anything, I know it's good to go.
So you have to get out there and hit tight, you know. You don't make no difference. You say, I'm going. I know I got to get tight, but I'm going anyway. Whatever happens, let it happen. I got to pay the dues.
What I find useful when I'm taking care of getting out an old cotter pin, I cut the loop I can see, then fold back, pull one half out at a time. It's not a revolutionary idea, but it does work well for me.
But I woke up cold and hand, yeah. I dream I had you all by myself. But now I know you found you another man, yeah. Oh, that's why. Pull a matchbox.
Boom. Lovely tool. Highly recommend it.
Well, a matchbox hold my clothes, yeah, yeah. You know I haven't got so.
Okay, so I've got the new parts, original rod. I'm gonna take this off, counting the threads, thread this back on at the same length, then do the other side, reattach it, pull the other rod and tie rod, and then do the same thing on its two ends. So this should go pretty quick and easy. I am using Moog parts, good reputation, not terribly expensive. You know, 20, 25, 30 bucks, depending on what you're buying. This one's obviously a little bit more expensive. So, getting to it. zerk fitting. Cool. Old and done. Alright, back to do the install.
Because the chief flag my train, buddy. I'm bound to let her ride well.
Okay, one side done. Now I gotta get over there.
Well, a matchbox hold my clothes. Hey, sometimes I wonder, darling.
Quick point of interest, possibly. Notice that this one is straight and this one has a slight bend in it. The slight bend goes on the driver's side tie rod. See the slight bend there? I actually like this one a little bit better. The bend is in the arm rather than in the actual ball joint itself, whereas this one has been bent slightly there. So anyway, pop these off just as before and reinstall and go from there. Plenty of thread engagement there. Jeez. So now I just gotta count the threads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is at 7. So, another 4. Revolution. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, so that's in the right spot. I'm going to tighten this up a bit with the idea that I don't want it to move in terms of unrolling. But I do need it to be slightly loose so that if I have to angle this slightly differently in order to get these two to both engage, I can do that. So, next. Some of these wee bit sticky if you look in there. A lot of gunk. So let's count the threads first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go.
Ah, but choose is just as bad. Yeah, they call it Stormy Monday. But choose is just
pretty torn up ball joint cap. One reason why I'm replacing them, you know? Okay, small unfortunate discovery. The one of the two that I bought for the driver's side tie rod is incorrect. So whether I ordered the wrong one or I ordered two of the, I don't know what. These threads pitch the wrong way, so can't use it. Replaced the boot using a new castle nut, put it back to where it was. Plenty of grease was still left in the joint, so that was good. And it moves freely, there's no binding. I don't see any rust pitting, no discoloration. So we're gonna call that good, but it is obviously not ideal. But I'm not gonna hold up this project. I gotta get moving. I gotta get a lot done this month. So I think we're good to go. I'll also say they gave the wimpiest little cotter pins. These things are skinny, so I am replacing them with upgraded ones. A little bit thicker, a little better. Alright, getting to it.
Lordy, much on me. I cried, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on me.
All that's left now is the steering damper.
Hey, you know, I'm trying to find my woman. Somebody please send her back to me.
Old one had this bracket on it. A little bit mangled, but I'm still going to use it. Quick, this bushing does not fit around the end bolt right there, so what I'm going to do is put this in my vise, drill it out ever so slightly because it's off by maybe a mil, and then pop it back on. Be right back. Done. Just used a 7/16 bit, which worked. Now it should. There we go. I'm putting the washer on first. Didn't come with one, but I want one on there. Okay, quick wrap up. New ball joint over there with Zerk fitting. Original rod connects down to there. Then we have the steering damper. Kind of a weird setup here. You can see the washer I put on, and then it came with one of these weird sort of hollow nuts. You can see that there, that I just kind of threw on top. Whatever, it's pretty locked in there. I will actually, I think I'll come back after I finish this up and put a little bit of Loctite on that. Don't want it coming loose. Then we've got the next ball joint. That is the one that I did not replace, but I did replace the boot and the castle nut, and that comes over to a new ball joint here with also a Zerk fitting. So anyway, I've got it all buttoned up, so now I just got to put the gas tank back in, and then I can head back over to the painting if the weather turns better. So thanks for watching. If you like what you see, please subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a comment. If there's anything you guys want me to do more of or less of, I don't have a plan when I put together the episodes, whether it's going to be 10 minutes or 38 minutes. I just put in as much detail as I can without trying to be too boring. If they're too long, let me know. If they're too short, let me know. If there's, I don't know, anything you want to see me do differently, go ahead and give a suggestion. But most of this is just me video logging it for myself and having some fun with the editing and music and all that stuff. So anyway, I will talk to you guys later. Oh, the nest of wiring. Got to do that pretty soon. See you guys.